going on, you guys? We're back with another video. It's Mr. Wildcard with Wildcard Lawn Care. Today, I think we're gonna make another purchase. We're gonna go get another weed eater. So of course, you know, it's gonna be a still, but I think it's gonna be either probably the FS91 or higher. So we're gonna go in there and check it out, see what our distributor has. You know, it's a smaller distributor, but you know, friend and family and stuff like that, you know, it's loyalty. You gotta keep it local, take care of the small people, because they're gonna take care of you. I've never had a problem. Every time I go in there with something, they're always there to help me out, fix some of my equipment on the spot. You know, it's just that good relationship you have with your dealer. So check it on out. We're gonna head over there after work. We're on a lunch break right now, cruising in style a little bit. We definitely gotta switch up the vehicles, because can't be hauling equipment around in this thing. So we'll go get the Too Fast Too Hurst, the HHR, so we can get out there. We've got three lawns to do today. We're gonna get out there and bang them on out, see what we can do. I'm thinking maybe the transmission in the little gears to make my mower go. I think it's getting a little weak, but it's probably understandable because I attached the striping kit to it, and that's pretty heavy. That helps me create those lines and stuff like that. So basically, if I took it off, that thing flies. I'm talking about super goes fast. But the thing with going super fast is you're not always getting the greatest cut, which I've noticed. Like, sometimes it pushes the grass over, you know what I mean? I'd really like to maybe even try out the 21 inch to see how that one cuts the same way too, because it seems like I always have a little bit of stragglers. It's kind of like a little mohawk every now and then if I'm going too fast. So sometimes if the grass is too tall, I gotta slow it down a little bit. And I'll try to get some video, let you guys see what I'm talking about. And yeah, I'm excited. Always excited to get new equipment, right? All right. What's up, you guys? We just went and go look at the weed eaters. Like I said, you know, looking at maybe picking up the still, maybe the FS91. Went in there. Of course, they're still open and stuff like that. But my person I usually buy from, he's out in California. I guess at the big Gravely dealer rep meeting or something like that. So they say he's gonna be back probably this week, so we're gonna probably hold off until he gets back so we can go ahead and pick that weed eater up. It is what it is. We'll get it this week coming up. So, you know, he's gonna be able to let me know all the new mowers that are coming out and then whatnot, and we'll probably look at trying to put our order in for next season, you know what I mean? So we'll see what we can what we're gonna come up with, see what prices they're coming up with and whatnot. And yeah, we'll make it work. It's okay. And like I said, now we're gonna run on to our next yard. It's one of the green pal yards. It's a little bit farther away. I've been a little, you know, iffy on this yard. I mean, I like it, they're good, but it's still kind of, it's getting kind of out of my route a little bit. Like I said, I'm trying to close my route up. Maybe next season when I can really organize it, you know, maybe put all of my yards in this area together, because I didn't really get a chance to do that. That's the only thing bad about, like, I don't like about Green Pal is a lot of people that change it when they freely and when they want to. They can kind of put me in a bind sometime. But, you know, I could have been more proactive on the app and maybe canceled it out the dates that they want, and you know, had a talking to with them about maybe doing it on certain dates or certain times of the week or something like that. So that's what I'm gonna look at. That's what I'm gonna focus really next season on. And I'm getting really excited, you know what I mean? I've been putting a little bit of the money away for the mower, so we'll see what happens, and we'll make it work. So we'll get out to this yard and get a little bit of action for you.
What's going on, you guys? We're here at our first green pal lawn. Did the flower bed for him, hooked it up a little bit, and then we're gonna see what we can do for this lawn, see if we can get some nice little lines on here. Yeah, we got the builders next door, you know, jamming on out to the music. It's all good. Got love for everyone. So yeah, check it out. Let me know what you guys think. Stop. Stop. As you guys can see, we got a little bit of stripes off that one. Better cut a little bit lower on this one because they're bi-weekly. I didn't want it to get too out of control with all the rain and stuff like that. So check it out. All right, guys, we just got done with that last lawn. It's a bi-weekly. They wanted to go weekly there for a little bit, but I kind of was a little bit too busy, so I didn't really get them on the weekly. Maybe I should have, but we'll probably look at doing something like that maybe next week and stuff like that. Just this kind of a little bit out of my route every week to always get out here. But you know, they've been a pretty good customer since the very kind of beginning. So, you know, we got to still kind of take care of them. Decide if we're really going to try. We're going to decide if we're really going to try, you know, maybe next season or something like that. See if we're going to keep them along or something. But if we get more yards out here, we can dedicate one day out here. Yeah, we probably will keep them. This is probably, honestly, it's one of my favorite areas to mow because I don't really have to worry about the grass getting too crazy, because a lot of these homeowner associations, you know, they'll get onto them if their grass isn't, you know, cut or where it needs to be. Where advice, like in the city where I'm at there in OKC, it can get a little bit crazier. I've had some big lawns, and because everybody's budget's a little bit different, and you know, I'm trying to still appease them but still make money and still keep it easier on me. So maybe I try getting in there every 10 days on some of these people. And then, heck, I have some of my customers that they'll just call me out of the clear blue. They're like, hey, I know I'm scheduled for Friday, can you come today? And if I got time in my schedule, yeah, I can make that happen. You know, as long as I got a little bit of fair warning or something like that, I can always make it happen. So we're going on to our next one. This next one's another green pal yard. He just books me to do his backyard. So basically, I just go in there, weed eat the backyard, mow the backyard, call it a day. And that's it, you know what I mean? So I might be able to try getting him maybe next season. Maybe I can start doing both his lawns, but I think he enjoys doing his front lawn. So, cause he's in, you know, one of those neighborhoods where they got the really, really fine grass, but they like to keep it really, really short. And the backyard's kind of like, you know, wild, wild west back there, you know what I mean? It's got a little bit of crabgrass problem, which, honestly, that's probably my least favorite is yards that have crabgrass and they don't do nothing about it, because it always seems like it don't matter how good I mow it, you always get that one strand that wants to go down and then pops right back up. So it gets really annoying. But yeah, we'll get the camera out there, see what I'm talking about, so you guys can see. And I know his grass is probably gonna be a little bit crazier because, you know, he said he was good last week, and we're just gonna have to wait and see. Can't stop. hands full with that backyard, but that's all I do in his yard is just the backyard. And yeah, you can tell that, you know, he pushed his time back a little bit, you know, because he really was his grass was overgrown, you know what I mean? It's kind of big, you know what I mean? And that's just usually a quick little yard, but it always makes it difficult when it gets tall like that. And you know, I really can't really mulch it too much. So what I do is I gotta take and put the discharge chute on the back, and then, you know, I do my little bit of lines when I can. You know, if it's too thick, I can't. I just gotta go to the outside. Just keep on outlining the whole yard going in like that, so I'm not rerunning over the grass. So if I can get it all together, that's when I'll take the blower, and then I'll take the blower and kind of blow the lines away. You know what I mean? Make it look as best as I can. I know it's gonna change probably next season once I get the rider. You know, like I said, I'm gonna get, you know, something with more power. I mean, this is a good lawnmower, but the 25 inch doesn't do the greatest in tall grass. It kind of like pushes and bends it over a little bit, and I gotta redo it twice, recut. I know, you know, it's gonna get easier if I had, like, you know, the pro stance or something like that, or one of the right standers or whatnot. You know, I could just hit it really, really quick. So, you know, I'm really looking forward to next season. You know, I'm waiting to see what they're gonna be coming out with with Gravely, because like I said, you know, my contact is the guy I get all my stuff from. He's a Gravely dealer, and he's out in Cali right now, so I guess they're showing them all the new stuff. So on to the next lawn. I know this one's gonna be kind of crazy because I just drove by and seen it, and they called up. They usually had a little bit of me doing a little bit of like trim work and stuff like that, and then I didn't hear from them a little bit of time, and I guess the wife or something like that left the son, and it's a mother now. She's having to handle it. So I told her, yeah, we're gonna come over and check it out, take care of it for him. She's like, I'm gonna have to overpay because I know the grass is overgrown, but we'll check it out, see what we can think. I know the backyard is probably gonna be crazy because usually that's how it is. So we just got done with that last lawn. As you can see, the back was pretty bad. Lawn was pretty bad. It almost looks like they put like Roundup or something like that on the ground, like, because it's like dead grass, but it was grown grass. So I'm probably gonna have to really go home and just wash my clothes really good. And got somebody out there, you know, doing their lawn, they're grinding on their own lawn. He'd be relaxing right now, paying somebody like me to do it, but that's okay though. Gotta give him props for getting it done. So yeah, we're just wrapped up for the day. Had our two green pal lawns, because green pal start shaking you down, lock you out, and you know what I mean, after you can only reschedule one time, and then you gotta cancel and redo your stuff. So that's the only thing that kind of sucks with that. You know, it gives too much power to the client. But it's okay though, it's helped me better my route. And yeah, today was kind of a busy little day. You know, we wanted to go get the weed eater, but our guy was gone, so we're gonna wait. And yeah, we'll see what tomorrow has in store.